Today is my first time ever shooting slide film, and for some reason I thought it would be a good idea to shoot expired slide film. So yeah, today I'm shooting some expired slide film. More specifically, this Fuji Provia 400F, which expired in 2005. Now, this was my first time ever shooting slide film or color positive film, and it's also my first time ever shooting with expired film full stop. So maybe it's a little bit ambitious tackling both at the same time, but I saw a great deal online and I thought it'd be a bit of fun to shoot and probably act as a good learning experience as well. It's a widely accepted rule that you have to add one stop of light for every decade that the film has expired, and I had no idea how the film was stored before it got to me, so I shot both rolls at 1.5 stops under its box speed of 400. Essentially rating the film at an ISO of 160. I actually vlogged for half of this video where I took a little trip with my friend Joe and shot one of the rolls through my Hasselblad 500C, and I'll play that later in the video with all of the results and my thoughts on those images. But I did shoot one of the rolls just as I went on a little casual walk with my parents. I'd recently picked up the RZ67 and had only used it a couple times, and I took that out with me and documented my little walk and took a few images that I was actually pretty happy with. The sharpness of the Mamiya lenses was one of the first things that I noticed when I got these scans back from the lab. They're so incredibly detailed, and also the grain of the film is actually super fine. Fujifilm states that when released, it was the finest grain available to ISO 400 color reversal film, whilst maintaining color saturation that rivals other ISO 100 films. So it was great to have that flexibility of extra light, meaning that of course I had to rate it lower than it was, and I got super fine grain and some really nice colors that are typically associated with ISO 100. Slide film. And I have to say, the colours and tones of that first roll I actually really liked, and I probably got one or two images that I was really happy with. Now, for the second roll that I shot, as I said, I tried my hand at vlogging as I took a trip down to my friend Joe's and we documented a sunrise and sunset, and I made some images with my Hasselblad 500C. I'll let this section play and then I'll give my thoughts on the images and the trip as a whole afterwards, but I do have to warn you that there were a couple little issues with my audio. This first clip in particular has a few pops and crackles from the microphone, but I promise that it does get better afterwards. We are headed to, where are we headed? Lulworth Cove for a little sunset photo shoot in Joe's van. This is the van that we went camping in. I'm shooting all of these videos before I've released a single video, so I don't know when.
In real life it was two weeks ago.
In the video it could have been months ago. I don't know when this is going out. We've had a nice time, we've gone to a pub, had a nice lunch, and we're gonna go take some photos of the sunset. I have got some slide film, some color positive film. I think it's Fuji Superior, I'm not actually sure. And it's my first time ever shooting color positive film, and it's also my first time shooting expired film.
And vlogging,
and my first time ever vlogging. So there's a lot of firsts this evening. It could go terribly. I don't know how the photos are gonna turn out. I don't know how I'm really gonna expose them, but we're gonna see. Hopefully we'll get some nice weather. The clouds are turning pretty nice already. Getting towards golden hour. Hopefully we will get some nice photos. We're halfway, pretty much up the hill. We're halfway there, well, a little over halfway. The sun over there, it just looks immense. I'm sharing both my footage and Joe's footage again. You'll have seen some of the clips. It's incredible here. I mean, the sunlight, I think it's sort of dipping behind clouds now, so we might need to get a bit of a move on. I'm hoping that the light stays amazing. Being told to hurry up, so I'll meet you at the top. Update, I have the Hasselblad out. I loaded it, it's the first time I've loaded it in a long time. We're gonna start shooting. So, I
think we've got to where we're going to start shooting. I have the Hasselblad
ready to go.
It's not ready for a shot yet. I haven't set it up. I've literally just put it down. We're going to start shooting before the light disappears too quickly, I think. So the light has been amazing. It's been an incredible little sunset. I obviously don't know if the film is any good. I don't know if the Hasselblad light leaks that I've had previously. I haven't actually spoken about, but I had light leaks in them previously, and I don't know if they're any good, if I fixed them, but I'm sort of just enjoying the moment now. I've taken some. Look at that, eh? But I think I'm just gonna enjoy the moment now. Tripod is sketching me. The last of the light is pretty much gone. You can see it just over there. I'm hopeful for the photos. I don't know how they're gonna turn out. I haven't used the Hasselblad for a long time. I've never shot this film. I've never shot expired film, and I've never shot slide film. And I sort of wanted to take this trip more as seeing how exposure works with it, what the colours sort of look like, what the exposure latitude is. Obviously, I know the dynamic range isn't as good as like a Port 400, but it's been good fun. We're gonna get up and shoot sunrise in the morning as well. So if the next thing you see is the sunrise, then good night, I guess. So I've taken one shot. The light is sort of just looking pinkish over the hills. Just over there. I'm gonna wait and maybe take another one in a few minutes just to see if the light gets a little bit more pinky and see what the difference is. I think that'll be the first roll of, I'm not even sure what it is I'm shooting. I think it's Provia, but it might be Velvia, but I think it's Provia.
It's one of the Vias.
Yeah, it is a Via. But it is lovely up here, just super cold. Thank you. going back down now. I took one more shot, I think, of that same light. What is my hair doing in the wind? The sun really never sort of came out. It sort of slightly clouded over a little bit, and now it's sort of just daylight. So I only took two images of sunrise, but we're gonna go home, grab a coffee, have a look at the footage and see what it looks like. But it was still a good experience, even if it was really cold.
So whilst the trip was great fun and my hair seemed to want to make fun of me the entire time, it was windy, and in that last clip in particular, I don't know what was going on, but in regards to the images, these ones I probably wasn't quite as happy with. Firstly, this roll, and I don't know if this is down to the expired film or my Hasselblad, but it had some sort of vertical streaks going down the film, almost looking a bit like a zebra crossing. I've had light leaks in my Hasselblad before, but not like this. They were all coming up from the corner and they seemingly were fixed. I replaced the foam seals in the film back and it looked like they were all fine. But obviously this film, it had sort of more vertical lines, so I assume it was either an issue with the film or maybe with the shutter in the Hasselblad, because obviously that would create more vertical lines. But if you know more than I do, feel free to leave a comment down below with your thoughts as to why you think these images came out the way they did. The scenes that I was taking photos of were also probably a little bit too contrasty. They had super bright highlights and super dark shadows with the setting sun and the rising sun. So for color positive film, it's ideal not to have that much dynamic range. So something like color negative film, where the highlights don't blow out nearly as easily, probably would have been a bit more suited to the situation, but there were still some awesome colors that came out in that sunrise and that sunset. Again, the images had super fine grain, some really lovely saturated colors, and there were a couple compositions that I didn't mind overall. But looking back at the images, I definitely prefer the way that the images from the Mamiya came out, and I don't know if that's due to not having issues with the film, but they just sort of render nicer tones, nicer contrast, and overall I just prefer that first set of images to this second set. But even if the images from this trip didn't come out as well as I had originally hoped, I definitely learned a lot going forward and shooting slide film in the future, how to meter it a little bit better, and just how to get the best out of this sort of film. I had an awesome trip, enjoyed an incredible sunset and a slightly less incredible sunrise that was so incredibly cold and windy, but made some more great memories and learnt from my experiences. I do have one more roll of Provia 400F left to shoot, so hopefully in the near future I will get to shooting that and sharing it on the channel. I think I'd like to shoot some portraits with it to see how it renders skin tones and deals in that sort of situation. But I think that's it for this week. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, please feel free to go and check out Joe's channel. He made a little video on the trip focusing mainly on the videography side of things. Feel free to leave a like. Let me know down below in the comments if you've ever shot with 400F or your thoughts on these images, and feel free to hit the subscribe button if you want to see more of this type of content. That's all from me. Have an amazing week, and hopefully I'll see you next week.